Right, I just picked up a new Trent iPulse. It is 10,000 milliamps and it has a 500 times cycle use. You charge this thing up 500 times before essentially the battery wears out, I guess. It comes with these little attachments here for your phone, micro USB. This ancient cell phone thing, I don't even know what phone uses that anymore. LG phone, yeah, attachments. What is this? Another ancient attachment here, I don't know what the... Only ones I'm dealing with is this one and this one. Now I got my Galaxy Nexus here, which drinks battery. It's been off the charge for an hour and 16 minutes and it's already down to 79%. And I got the extended battery in this thing, so. Here's the device. I got this thing fully charged. It's about, it's a little taller than the Nexus. It's thicker than the Nexus. But not by a lot. It's really light. And it feels well built, so I feel like I could just pop this thing in my back pocket and I'll be good. Now it comes with this little USB adapter. You plug it into the wall and this end goes into the device with the adapter, but it doesn't come with a USB wall adapter. You have to have one of these. I'm using this from my Transformer Prime. They had some copyright issues and they're not allowed to give you like a device like this. So if you buy this straight out of the box and you don't have this, you're not going to be able to charge this. So I'm going to go out today solely depending on this. I'm not even going to charge my phone before I leave. I'm going to solely rely on this for my phone and my PS Vita. Let's see what happens. I just got back home and I used my new Trent portable charger. It worked really good on my cell phone. And it is totally useless on this PS Vita. Now with the device off, with the Vita off, it'll charge really, really slow. Really slow. And with the device on, this thing won't charge at all. Now I had it plugged up for at least 3 hours, and that's what I got from being fully dead. So it charges really slow. Like this is useless for the Vita. It works really good with the phone, and I'm at the point where I'm like, well, let's see if it'll charge my playbook. Plug my playbook up. Now this is it has the 2-volt and the single volt operation here. Yeah, it's the 1-volt and 2-volt. I mean either way it wouldn't charge that Vita to anything that was acceptable. That thing is useless for that. Now I'm going to try it with my playbook. And no, it is not charging that. No. and that is the 2-volt side. Yep, that's the 2-amp side, pardon me. 5-volt, 2 amps. No, that's not doing anything for that either. Let me see if it'll charge my transformer. Now I'm actually recording with the transformer, so I can't show. No, it's not charging the transformer either. Oh, wait a minute. I didn't even turn it on. Pardon me. I'll just try it now. Nope. Not being charged. And if it is, it's really slow. Now, for me, it's fine. It works with my cell phone. That's good enough. But if you're looking to replace, you know, if you're looking to get something for your Vita or your tablet, this thing is not going to charge it. Unless it's, maybe if it's off, I'm not sure. Let me move it. No. These devices require so much power. Man, this is not doing anything. Well, that's the new Trent iPulse. And that's it.